A lot is going on in space. Humans are finalizing plans to return to the moon. Mars exploration is now a thing, and we could find another livable planet or even aliens any moment now. But there are a lot of more mysterious things to worry about, like the 1950 DA asteroid that might wipe us out, or a geomagnetic storm that could cripple our communication systems. Join us in today's video as we walk you through some of the most epic upcoming space events that the future holds for us. Have you ever wondered what the effects of a geomagnetic storm in space would be? Well, you don't have to wait that long to experience it. But the bad news is, when it happens in 2025, all our technology-based infrastructure, including the internet, could be destroyed. Spacecrafts would have a hard time flying, and NASA would struggle to control the satellites in orbit. A geomagnetic storm is actually not an unusual event. The first and most serious solar flare to date, the Carrington event, took place in September 1859. During the event, which was monitored by two British astronauts, there were several reports of strong aurora waves across countries like Cuba, Hawaii, Australia, Colombia, and in some parts of the United States. According to eyewitness reports, the aurora lit up the night skies so much that it was possible to read at night, and there were spontaneous fire breakouts at several telegraph stations. However, there were no major infrastructural or human casualties recorded. A similar storm in today's world could be much more disastrous. Since then, we've had at least one massive superstorm every 11 years, when the sun's north and south magnetic poles switch and hundreds of billions of magnetically charged matter are released into the solar system. But so far, we've been incredibly fortunate to avoid them. We got lucky in 2012 too, when a similarly massive storm missed our planet by whiskers. And just recently, on March 14th, a geomagnetic storm missed the Earth by only 9 days. If it didn't miss, you probably wouldn't have internet access to watch this video, nor any other stuff you used to. Scientists believe that we might run out of luck, and the next one in 2025 could literally leave us stranded, especially as solar activity continues to explode at unprecedented speeds. The scariest part is that no government on Earth has a crisis plan for that scenario, and no one really knows how we could deal with it. Without internet, telecommunications, GPS, and all our modern technology, we could find ourselves in medieval times again. Speaking about rare times, scientists claim that we are facing a long-awaited remnant that will approach us in July 2061, Halley's Comet. The solar system is decorated with numerous comets, but Halley's Comet remains the most iconic of them all. It was first seen in 240 BCE and associated with bad omens back in the days. Since then, astronomers have spotted it in different regions, including Babylonia, China, India, Japan, the Middle East, and Europe, as the comet repeatedly passes through the inner solar system. However, its movements and appearances weren't really documented until 1705, when British astronomer Edmund Halley concluded that the three comets that appeared in 1531, 1607, and 1682 were the same object. He predicted that this comet would make a return in 1758. Although he missed the deadline by a few months, the comet appeared as Halley had predicted. Unfortunately, he died in 1742 at the age of 85, so he couldn't witness the event. Consequently, scientists renamed the comet after him in honor of his efforts and discovery. But more importantly, public opinion has swayed in favor of Halley's Comet so much that many professionals and amateur cosmologists look forward to its appearance, which happens once every 75 years on average. That's the life expectancy of a human on Earth. So if you're lucky enough to witness Halley, enjoy that rare moment. Most likely, you won't make it to the next rare stuff coming up, but your descendants could. Since it was discovered in 1930, Pluto has gone from being a full-fledged planet to being classified as a dwarf planet. However, it is yet to complete a full orbit around the Sun. For Pluto, it takes 248 Earth years to do one orbit around the Sun. This is because of its enormous orbit metrics and not because it's slow. However, there are things that can take time on a dwarf planet. An average day on Pluto is equal to 6.4 days, or 153.3 hours on Earth. And owing to this fact, Pluto's orbital journey around the Sun won't be complete until March 23rd, 2178. Unlike most planets, Pluto rotates around the Sun from east to west. Venus and Uranus are the only two other planets that exhibit this trait. In addition, this dwarf planet, which is only about half the width of the United States, has an oval or elliptical shape and is also inclined at an angle of 17 degrees. Most likely, even your great-grandson or granddaughter will be old when Pluto finishes this very orbit that we're talking about right now. Fascinating, hey? Speaking about long-time periods, more than 800 years from now, human existence could be completely wiped out by a fast-travelling asteroid named 1950 DA, and there is little or nothing we can do about it, simply because this asteroid defies the laws of physics. According to Ben Rosites, a postdoctoral researcher, the 1950 DA is rotating faster than the breakout limit for its density. So if just gravity were holding this rubble pile together, as is generally assumed, it would fly apart. Therefore, interparticle cohesive forces must be holding it together, Rosites added. The scientist and his team confirmed this when they carried out an experiment to check 1950 DA's temperature and density. 1950 DA measures 1,000 metres in diameter and only rotates once in about 2.5 minutes, but it's able to travel at 38,000 miles per hour. This beast is set to hit the Earth with the highest probability on March 16, 2880. And if it eventually does, scientists believe that the force of the impact could reach 44,800 megatons of TNT. The thought of a potential collision is enough to scare the living daylights out of anyone. But that's no wonder, as a 1 millimeter object with a speed of 17,000 miles per hour could cut through a 20-inch wide metal cube. Future prospects after meeting with 1950 DA isn't the best, right? But even without this deadly asteroid, we'll have some interesting stuff coming up. Most people believe that the constantly changing distance between Earth and the Sun is responsible for the change in seasons. But in Earth's case, the distance between us and the Sun varies by 3% at most, and that's not enough to create the different seasons we experience. So, how is summer and winter created? The thing is, Earth doesn't rotate upright. Instead, its axis is tilted 23.5 degrees as it spins around the Sun. This angle changes from time to time. However, the Moon's gravitational pull ensures that it doesn't shift by more than a degree. However, as the Earth continues to orbit over time, the equinoxes and solstices will swap positions every 13,000 years. Hence, winter will become summer, and summer will become winter. But until then, we have some time enjoying the good old summer. The future, they say, is unpredictable. But scientists are quite certain that the world beyond will continue to serve us a steady dose of strange events.